Hey guys, Dr. Berg here. In this video, we're going to talk about vitamin D deficiency, okay? Now, vitamin D is mainly there to help you absorb calcium in the small intestine. The vitamin D helps absorb calcium by 20 times. So that's a lot. If you didn't have vitamin D, you're not going to absorb calcium that much. So it brings it from the intestine up into the blood, okay? It also helps lower blood pressure. So some people that are deficient have high blood pressure because of low vitamin D. It also affects the immune system. So if you have an immune deficiencies or autoimmune problems, vitamin D can actually help that. In fact, some of the microbes in certain diseases are very stealth and they block the receptor for vitamin D to cause you not to pull that thing in there to perpetuate the illness. It's really interesting. Also prevents asthma. So if you have if you're asthmatic and you go out in the sun and you get all the sun, you will actually reduce your symptoms greatly. So vitamin D deficiencies can set you up for asthma symptoms. If you're taking vitamin D, like 2,000 milligrams is not going to, or 2,000 international units isn't going to do anything. You need minimally 10,000 international units. Now, if you notice, I'm not saying milligrams. International units are units that are a lot different rating system, so you need a lot more to equal milligrams. So I probably, like, if you're out in the sun for 20 minutes, you're going to get 35,000 international units of vitamin D. So I mean, the sun will give you that. So you don't have to be concerned about taking too much vitamin D. I mean, you could take like 100,000. And still be okay, but the danger is not counteracting it with vitamin K2. I put some links down below if you don't know about vitamin K2 to get more data, but vitamin K2 works with vitamin D3 and together to transport calcium through the body. So what happens, vitamin K2 will take that calcium from the blood and push it into the bone. So it actually helps, it works with the vitamin D in the transportation of calcium, so you don't end up with soft tissue calcium or calcification in the arteries. Get the MK7 version, that's a natural. And then without vitamin D, you get bone pain, okay? And then also vitamin D is really good to prevent depression. So those, and especially that's why in the winter, people kind of get the blues. So let's just talk about what causes vitamin D deficiencies. Number one, gallbladder. If you don't have a gallbladder, then you're not gonna have the bile to emulsify and pull in the fat-soluble vitamin, vitamin D, or even K2. So that could be a problem. And if you don't have a gallbladder problems, then you need to take something, some bile extract to help you. And then cortisol. So in this book, Frank Netter, Encyclopedia of Endocrinology, Volume 4, talks about cortisol counteracting vitamin D. So that's interesting. So stress can block vitamin D. So here you are getting the sun, taking the vitamins, but it still shows low. Could be cortisol, could be high levels of cortisol, that's stress, that can block it. And that's why adrenal cases have a lot of issues with calcium because they have a vitamin D deficiency. So it also could be like it's in the winter, you don't get much sun. That could be a cause, in which case you want to take some extra virgin cod liver oil, which is the best source of vitamin D. And then it could be from your diet. You don't consume enough foods with vitamin D. So anyway, I just wanted to create a little video to give you a little summary of vitamin D and tell you some of the other connections that you might not be aware of. So thanks for watching.